So this is just article I wrote based on the, you go around in the field and you see such a large program being implemented. So these are some thoughts. There's also the fact that we do implementation with the Madhya Pradesh government of MGNREGA with panchayats. So some of the learnings are from there. And let me clarify also that I'm trying to make a distinction between, one, the idea of providing employment and the scheme which converts this idea into operational practice. And these observations are largely my thoughts on the scheme. So the idea part is separate. I think the idea is good. It's done a lot of good. But I have a problem with this. See, look at, when we look at employment, I was looking at a very good document written by Amartya Sen on employment. He talks about three aspects of employment. One is, of course, the income aspect. The second is the production aspect. And the third is the recognition or the dignity or the pride aspect of doing work. And if you talk to villagers anywhere, when they do good farming, when they are good artisans, even when they take this, you go to old villages, this is the labor market, there is a pride. They want all three. A good well digger will say, you know, I get so much money, but I'm a very good well digger. You show me a well anywhere, I can do it for you, I can do this for you. And with these wells only, this area is prospered. So there is a combination of all three where villagers talk about employment. My assessment is that the scheme is obsessively focused on only the wage aspect or the income aspect, and it has, and that's my major critique. And you know, this is when I used to go around, and you know, you go to a village, the scheme is there, as an NGO you do awareness building, etc., and then you find that the demand is not coming up. And so I used to ask people, listen, this is for you, you are unemployed, right? So this old guy came up and said, listen, you keep on saying that tomorrow haq hai, you know, it's a big thing, tomorrow haq hai, why are you not demanding? He said, yeah, what haq are you giving me? So is this, you think it's a great thing you're giving me? I dig up these meaningless pits, I put up roads which get washed away next year, and you think what do you think? You think I'm proud of him that I have to go and do this stupid work? So our perception, and that includes NGOs and government, we think what we are offering and what the perception is what they are getting, there is a huge difference, and we need to be humble enough to accept that there is a difference in this perception. And it's a very intriguing thing. In the whole of Western India, I have not seen a village which does not have a demand for water. And there is a very articulate, spoken demand which comes up. In these same villages, you know, you won't see this demand coming up. Not only Saurashtra, which may not need the labor, but even in South Gujarat. And that is because for most of them, the work is a means to an end. And here they don't see the end at all. They have no role to play in the end. They are not a participant in the preparation of the end or the planning for the end. They have just told this, you know, and in Nalanda, for example, 4 years the collector decided what would be implemented at Nalanda. And he said that there will be ponds dug up. There were not enough ponds, so they all were traveling 12 kilometers to dig up some other village's pond so that they could get labor. So then, you know, so therefore, that's the issue. And this, I think, is what my observation is, that all of us, we are all NGO people or whatever, that the people who have the best ideas may not be the best designers of schemes. Scheme designing is distinct from idea giving. And in this case, when you mix this up, you have this, I think, a bit of a mess. And this, there is, you know, I used to attend these early meetings of this, and there was this obsession that the moment you focus on the production aspect, then there will be local elite capture, and therefore don't even talk about, you just talk about 100 days and wage. Don't talk about production, don't talk about watershed, don't talk about dams, that's all, you know, then elite will capture. And this obsession has led to a very low priority to the production aspect, which they are trying to cover in NRGA 2, the new guidelines. And still a very low priority, almost no priority to the recognition aspect. No, I don't see any liberal coming and say, I'm a very proud MGNREGA worker. No, that's not there.
Except so, in Kerala.
For the women. And that's true because of Kudum Shri, and they've sort of added that part. So I think you need that, and that is what I would have expected everywhere, is that you recognize this and deal with all three parts of what I would call it. Actually, there are a lot of assumptions in the implementation of the scheme. And one is that the local government staff would help panchayats to develop plans, which is, you know, a fairly naive assumption in any circumstances. The second, that the panchayats already had the desire and the capacity to prepare compliant plans for their own development and involve the poor and women, and most panchayats don't do so voluntarily, and so that, you know, that shelf of works is prepared. And after having that plan, they have the capacity to, and we are implementing MGNREGA. It is a very complex scheme to implement. The amount of paperwork you have to do, you have to send daily reports. When we expect a panchayat to implement that, was, I thought, a very complex guidelines with lots of checks and balances. I think there's a far-fetched assumption happening there. And there is also a fourth assumption that, you know, outsiders would come and do a social audit, and therefore that's the self-correcting mechanism. You know, the way social audits are being just done, and we've been asked to do, last year we were asked the district administration to do social audits of 14 villages in 3 days. So, because, you know, Pima Pugya, so I think there are problems. There is MGNREGA works, favorable labor markets, dynamic character, there's a Pudukshi scheme, you know, where all these assumptions are somehow in this vast country, something somewhere can always work. And if we prove it, let's see if it works here, why doesn't it work elsewhere? I think these are, you know, very faulty ways to read the situation. There is a design problem.
Just a quick question for clarification, sorry to interrupt you. And when you say MGNREGA works, what do you mean by works and not work?
Oh, sorry, you mean all the,
you say,
no, that it leads to, you know, 100 days of labor, you know, gets their, you know, job cut full payment, productive assets are made, villages have created a demand, and it's not pushed by the state, which is what the ideal framework of the, you know, scheme was. So it works as per the scheme. So
when it works fruitfully.
Oh, fruitfully.
But there are
no so that does happen, and it has happened in many cases, a few cases scattered across the country. But I think those are exceptions because of this constellation of things happening, and they have not much to do with the changes in design which need to be made.
And that needs to be accepted.
The other problem we have with this universalization is already addressed it, so I won't know, but this is what we see happening in, let's say, a village in is, it's a wonderful win-win situation. Very, very good win-win situation. The laborer gets advanced 3,000 rupees. So he pushes up and does his labor work at 150 rupees a day. So he gets 3,000 in advance. He gives his job card. He does these pre-signed checks. Everything is done. Once he does that, then the sarpanch takes that, withdraws the money, hires the JCB contractor. The Gram Sabha has already decided 4 ponds to be desilted. And the ponds get desilted. So the JCP contractor makes money, there is surplus available for the surplus of the local authority, so they all are happy. The government is very happy because 2 years ago, Junagadh had higher utilization rates of MGNREGA than dams. Okay, just imagine that. So government is very happy that it shoots up the whole, state government is very happy with this kind of arrangement because, you know, at least utilization is good, central government will stop bothering them. And water housing structure is also done, so the village overall is happy. So actually, it's actually a super win-win situation. I'm not sure who loses, but this is what's happening on a large scale in all these category 1 areas, very systematically.
Okay.
In poorer areas, unfortunately, the same thing is happening, but at a great cost. Narmada hit already said, so I won't repeat it. Villages are migrating because they know that they won't get labor on the payment on time. And therefore, they take that advance, and they get a card, and they vamoose. So they end up with largely 2,000 to 3,000 rupees. I mean, their negotiating power is less. So Saurashtra negotiates for 3,000 in advance, this guy negotiates for 2,000 in dam, and then he pushes off, and then the whole system takes over. So this is what you have. So it's a very reverse, perverse scheme that if you have more money, then you have more patient, so you don't mind delayed payment, and you have more bigger voice, so you will have a more successful scheme. If you are poor, you have less patience, you are less empowered, and therefore the scheme comes less. So you know, this whole scheme somehow, area-wise has reversed itself. The last thoughts I have on, and some of these thoughts have been addressed in MGNREGA too. I still think this whole, you know, there is a whole need for separate agencies outside the state or separate from the local government to just work and capacitate the panchayats to prepare plans and whatever support they need to implement this thing. Let the panchayats be empowered, let them take it, but without this external capacity building, you know, this will not just happen. This assumption is totally wrong. And if you want to universalize it, if you can roll back this whole thing, then at least they do some targeting. And make the targeting so that the real poor benefit, and there are every rich area there are poor people, but make it targeted. And then the volumes will be so low, the money, that the elite will not have any interest in, you know, there's not enough money for them to get involved, so maybe some good will be done with in those areas. But you know, otherwise, you know, this is an issue. I've just got some case studies in MP, and I've seen the work in MP, in Andhra Pradesh, in many areas, where with good administration, good support, you can actually change the face of a village. I mean, imagine a village of 200 households getting, what, 300 households, 200 households, 20 lakhs an annum, or 25 lakhs an annum of money available to do village development. You do that for 5 years, you are a crore in a village. A crore in a village, every village can become a highway bazaar or a rally house. But that's not happening because of, I think, there is a design issue there. That's it.